Hello students of class 9 standard. Today we will continue the video of the Archimedes principle. Okay, few part maybe already you have started. So before starting the Archimedes principle, we just first I will try to explain what is actually the upthrust. Upthrust means what? In case when a body is kept in a particular place inside a liquid, or if you talk about in the air atmosphere also, one different type of force which is opposite to the gravitational force will develop. That type of force is called the upthrust or the upward directional force, you can also tell. So whenever a body is placed in a particular portion inside the liquid, wherever maybe it is fully immersed or partially immersed, that doesn't matter. If it is having a some amount of mass, then its weight will act in a downward direction, which is always denoted as m into g. W equal to m into g, we all know that. And as liquid is also present, liquid will give a upward directional force, okay, which is known as upthrust, FB, which is buoyant force, you can also tell that one. So that's why FB. So this is the thing. Next thing is that whenever a body will be placed inside a liquid, definitely its weight will just reduce. How that particular weight is called the apparent weight of the body. So some loss of weight you can easily see there. How can you calculate that amount of loss of that weight? Suppose if you want to calculate that one, that loss weight or the weight loss of the body. So loss of weight, suppose you are going to calculate, then it should be actually the actual weight. Actual weight of the body minus upthrust. Okay, so if the body's actual weight may be 100 kgf, okay, so then definitely its weight will just lose there, that will lose there. Why lose there? Because actually weight is just going in a downward direction, weight is always acting in the downward direction, but upward directional force acts in that particular body. So definitely a loss of weight you can easily see. Now actually the total loss is actually, now from here if you want to calculate the upthrust, then what you will write? Upthrust is actually, from this formula you have to write that actual weight minus the loss weight or the weight loss of weight, you can also write. So this is actually the Archimedes principle in a simple mathematical form. If you want to write down that one, then what we know, that upthrust is equal to what? That is equal to V into rho into G. What are these things? V is the volume of the water displaced or the liquid displaced. This is the density of the liquid and G is the gravity. Now if you want to just reduce this one in a single, in a particular form, then what you will get? We know that one, volume, density is equal to what? Mass by volume. So if you want to write down this one, mass divided by volume, and G is already there, then these two volume will cancel out and you will get M into G. And what we have already written, that Mg is what? Mg is one type of weight there. Okay, so weight of what? This weight is not actually the gravitational weight. This weight is the amount of weight of the liquid which is displaced from a particular position. Definitely if you want to place a body inside a liquid, few amount of weight liquid will be displaced. What will be the weight of that one? That is actually the upthrust. So this is only the Archimedes principle. Now the theory or the Archimedes principle, what he told that one, actually according to Archimedes, that when a body is immersed in a particular liquid, partially or wholly immersed, then upward directional force, that means upthrust, will be experienced, will be developed, and that amount of upthrust is equal to the weight of the liquid displaced. So that is only, so this is, so the weight of the liquid displaced is equal to upthrust. That is only the Archimedes principle. So few experiments are also done according to that one. So I am writing this one, this Archimedes principle, in a short form, that of thrust is equal to the weight of the liquid displaced. For the weight of the liquid displaced, this is called the up thrust. This is actually the up thrust, and this is only the Archimedes principle. Now, some experiment we are doing now. What we are doing in your book, it is given one portion of a physical balance which is connected first initially here. Physical balance, this one is the one hand of the physical balance is there. It is connected with first initially with a hollow cylinder. Okay. One spring is connected and one solid cylinder is also connected here. This one is solid one and this one is a hollow one. Now initially what we are doing, just when this, suppose this is A and this is B, two cylinders are there. So if you just see that one, now if you calculate some amount of weight will show in the physical balance, some amount of weight will definitely come in the physical balance. Now what we are doing, just we are placing this particular cylinder, the solid cylinder, inside a liquid. Okay, in this way we are just putting this cylinder inside a liquid. What thing you will get? The weight will be reduced. The weight will just lost there. Why? Because it will be experienced by a upward directional force. Up thrust will be acted on that one. So definitely it will try to go in upward direction. So weight loss you can see here. Now what we are doing, this one is a hollow cylinder, we have already told that one. So you have measured the weight of the weight loss, you have measured how much weight has lost, okay, when you kept this one inside a liquid. Now you have put few amount of liquid on that one. Okay, now you, whenever you will put few amount of liquid on this cylinder, then the actual weight will come up. Okay, or if suppose this is 10 gram or 10 something, the 10 kgf suppose liquid is there, if you put 10 kgf here, then the same value will come back. Okay, so this is the thing. Whenever, what is actually the thing, that up thrust is equal to the weight of the liquid displaced. How much liquid has displaced, that you put here, and that will be just actually equal to the up thrust of the body. So this is the experimental verification of the Archimedes principle. Okay, so in this way you can just explain the Archimedes principle. Next thing is that how the sinking and the floating condition is depending on the density of the body and the liquid. Okay, so sinking condition, suppose you are talking about, or the floating condition you are talking about in respect to the density of the liquid. Okay, so we know that suppose a body, any body you have taken, which is having m amount of mass, which is definitely acted upon by a g amount of gravitational force in the downward direction, so it will definitely have a weight, which is a true weight of the body when it is in air. So what is the value? That is m into g. Or you can write down, if the density of this body is rho amount, so you can write down the volume, if the volume is V amount, volume of this body, then V into rho into g. Okay, so V into rho into g will be the actual weight of the body, you can write down. Because we know that density equal to mass by volume, if you cut the volume, then same value will come back. Okay, and up thrust you will also know. When the floating and sinking condition will come up, then definitely up thrust will also come in your consideration. So up thrust or the FB amount, this one is actually also can be written in the form that V into rho L into G, where V is what? V is the volume of the water displaced or the liquid displaced, rho is the density of the liquid, and G is the gravity. Okay. Now if you relate them together, now you have put this body inside a liquid, maybe in this way, then what will come? You have to see that whether, suppose this one will come up, that W is greater than FB, then you have to write down V into rho into G will be greater than V into rho L into G. So you can simply write down that rho is greater than rho L. What is the condition? weight is greater than FB. That means this one is greater than this one. So downward directional force is greater, upward directional force is less. So definitely the body will try to go in downward direction. It will not float, it will sink. If the reverse condition will come up, similarly, second condition, if rho L is greater than rho, then definitely the body will float. If the third condition, that means both will be equal, then also the body will float. Okay, so these are the conditions. Okay, so in the next video, I will just try to complete the that exercise work, exercise question. Okay, thank you for today.